The sun, a blazing ball of red, was just now setting behind us, and its level rays fell upon the man we were chasing. He stood on the very edge of the rocks, a black spot against the luminous yellow of sea and sand. He seemed to be meditating. His back was towards us, and he perceived neither his pursuers above, nor the heads that at this moment appeared over the ridge behind him, and not 15 yards away. The party on the beach had dismounted and were clambering up stealthily. 5 seconds more and they could spring upon him, but they underestimated a madman's instinct. As if for no reason, he gave a quick start, turned, and at the same instant was aware of both attacking parties. A last gleam of sunlight fell on the snuff box in his left hand. His right thumb and forefinger hung arrested, grasping the pinch. For fully half a minute nothing happened. Hunters and hunted eyed each other and waited. Then carrying the snuff to his nose, and doffing his hat, with a satirical sweep of the hand and a low bow, he turned again and tripped off the ledge into the jaws of the quick boy. There was no help now. At his third step the sand had him by the ankles. For a moment he fought it, then, throwing up his arms, sank forward, slowly, and as if bowing yet, upon his face. Second by second we stood and watched him disappear. Within 5 minutes the ripples of the quick boy sand met once more above him. In the course of the next afternoon the Vassar of Bleakirk called at the hall with a paper which he had found pinned to the church door. It was evidently a scrap torn from an old letter, and bore, scribbled in pencil by a clerkly hand, these words: "The young Squire Catwright in Straits by the footbridge, 6 miles toward Netherkirk. Oriate pro anima Guliam Lee Teague." The Countess of Bellarmine by Arthur Quiller Couch. Few rivers in England are without their lover's leap, but the tradition of this one is singular, I believe.